Heroes in the spotlight for putting their lives on the line for the sake of others during the COVID-19 pandemic.
And for the first time in the history of the EMS Awards, there were two winners selected for the Lifetime Achievement Award. News 3 reporter Antoinette Delbel has their story.
Two exceptional individuals with storied careers, dedicating more than 40 years of service to their communities. Dennis Keene and James Hoffler are just some of the unsung heroes in EMS.
They are top-notch, class act. They maintain that level of compassion, that level of empathy.
The men, along with several other regional EMS personnel, were just recognized by the Tidewater EMS Council during its annual ceremony that, because of COVID, was held virtually. And for the first time in its 30-plus years, there were two winners for the Lifetime Achievement Award, Keene and Hoffler.
All the men and women I met along the way that just made it a very valuable career. It makes the award that much more valuable because I know it came from my peers.
Keene retired in June as the district chief of the Virginia Beach Fire Department. Hoffler retired in July as the Portsmouth fire chief. He says the already challenging job in EMS was even more taxing for his crew at the start of the COVID-19 pandemic.
When we get called to go somewhere, we get to the front door and something bad's happening, we don't have the option to leave.
Hoffler and Keene also dedicated countless hours volunteering in their communities. Their notable careers at times crossed paths, both men serving as Nightingale flight medics and on the FEMA Virginia Task Force 2. Keene was part of the search and rescue effort after the Oklahoma City bombing.
I went there as a paramedic. Unfortunately, we did not find any survivors.
Hoffler began his career in 1974 as an EMT and was one of the region's first cardiac rescue technicians before joining the Portsmouth Fire Department.
I was born into a fire department family. It's been in my blood, still in my blood.
All award recipients will now advance to the Governor's EMS Awards program for a chance to receive statewide recognition for their dedication and service. We thank all the frontline workers and wish them the best. Antoinette Delbel, News 3.